Now, Lazarus was sitting at the table, and I thought to myself, oh, what's so good about him sitting at a table? What's so, you put, but he was sitting at the table, but he was sitting at the table. The table represents fellowship. You can have fellowship and not worship. You have a lot of people who come to have fellowship. They come with their own agenda. See, the thing about fellowship, when you look it up, it says friendly association, and usually coming to have a common interest. And some people come with the interest of, what can I get out of it? They don't come to say, I'm coming to service to see what I can get of God. What can I get out of it? See, the dance is good, right? But unless it changes your thinking, when you walk up out of here, you will be spiritually anemic, because you will not have any type of color of the blood, and you will be weak and fatigued all week long when you come to have fellowship instead of have sweet communion with the Father. See, there's a difference between fellowship and communion. Communion means we know each other. We done had some type of intimate relationship. But fellowship means I see you when I see you. But see, the thing about it is, if you have that type of fellowship with him, then when you start to go through things and you have to build yourself back up, you know, see, when you have a relationship with God, you can just go down in prayer and say, Father, I stretch my hands to thee. But when you only have a fellowship with him, that's a now and then, you have to start off with, Father, please forgive me, and all of this other stuff. But see, when you go into a relationship with him, then when you get into some type of trouble, the good thing about God is, especially those who got the Holy Ghost, when you have the Holy Ghost, he gives you something called tongues. And when you don't have tongues, you live beneath your knee. See, because there's going to come a time where you are need to be lifted. And nobody else can give you the lift you need. Your mother can't do it. Your father can't do it. Your best friend can't do it. But when you enter that communion with God himself, and you have that tongue, and he gives you the unknown tongue, it's to edify yourself. You have a lot of people speaking in tongues, and he don't know what they're saying. Why? Because they're trying to point something towards you and trying to prove something. But he gave us the tongues. See, edifying means I'm talking about myself and building my own self up. See, prophecy is for you. But when we go off into that tongue, that's for me. Because you can't give me the lift that I need. I can't have a fellowship with him. I gotta have sweet communion. And when you come to the house of God, you can't come with your own agenda. See, the people that were there, Lazarus, yeah.